Hello and welcome to the 2020 Westside Film Festival. My name is Mark from All Sourced Up, and I'll be your host and compere for this year's competition. As some of you may know, back in 2018 we had the Westside Film Festival and it was held at the Woodville Town Hall. Because of the restrictions this year, unfortunately, we won't be doing that, but we'll be bringing this competition live to your living room. Firstly, I would just like to acknowledge that we are meeting on traditional country of the Kaurna people of the Adelaide Plains. We recognise and respect their cultural heritage, beliefs and relationships with the land. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we've got 9 amazing films to be showing you throughout the competition this evening. But firstly, let's just introduce some of our sponsors. There we go, once again, a big thank you to our competition sponsors. Now, first up, we are going to show you our 2018 winner of the Westside Film Festival, which was Charles Sturt in Time, directed by Michael Wilcock. Enjoy.
My name is Captain Charles Sturt, and I have been sent from the past to make sure the city of Charles Sturt holds up in honour of my name. So I decided to start at Point Malcolm Reserve. Not only does it provide sophisticated exercise equipment, the serenity is breathtaking. I then sailed off on a futuristic travel device which led me to the Woodville Town Hall. I approached some locals who were extremely happy to see me. They didn't say much, so I continued on my way. This friendly, vibrant place to live gives businesses the opportunity to thrive, like Cotto's, the local beverage hut. But I was thirsty to find out more. Thankfully, a helpful lady offered to show me around town, ending up at the Grange Golf Club. She explained Charles Sturt Council is considered the sporting and entertainment hub of Adelaide. I then met a true gentleman from the club. We played a lot of fun games together. I could tell he didn't want me to leave. He was really, really fond of me. Following the iconic linear park trail, I discovered many community facilities, such as libraries, social hubs, and schools. The diverse community all proved to be exceptionally friendly, such as these girls who told me I had no fashion sense, whatever that means. The many shops were just as stunning as Henley Beach itself. So, my final verdict is...
the West is best.
Well, how'd you go from 2018's winner? Did you enjoy Charles Sturt in Time? Hopefully so. Of course, we have got our 9 films, but let's just talk a little bit more about what we were actually focused on for our theme for this year, which was hidden gems within the city of Charles Sturt. Now, if you're like me, a resident of the city of Charles Sturt, you'll know this is an amazing place to live. But there's lots of little hidden bits and pieces that we might not be aware about, which our filmmakers are going to showcase in their 9 films for our competition. So without further ado, let's get started with our first 3 films.
Thank you. This is the only place I know on the Adelaide coast where you can actually, for a moment, have a glimpse of what this place was like before roads, before houses, before shopping centres. To be able to come here just in a few minutes from my own local backyard is a real privilege, and it reminds me how precious this is. I've been volunteering down here for 7 years, so I come and volunteer on the footsteps of people that have been volunteering a lot longer than me. And I like that sense that I get the chance to pick up the baton. It's deeply rewarding to collect the seeds and the cuttings, to propagate them, to come and plant them and water them. I enjoy many things about the dunes, but it doesn't matter how many times I've come here, every time I come here, there's a surprise. The bird song that we just heard will be different. Some days you see a lizard, a painted dragon. Some days you notice a plant that you haven't noticed before. And you learn something every time you come to this place. And it just fuels my commitment to make sure that those surprises, those joys are here for people in years to come.
Well, there we go. That's our first three films. What do you think? If you're one of those filmmakers, well done. Give yourself a pat on the back. You did an amazing job. And also set the standard really high for all the amazing films we're going to show throughout our competition. Did you notice when you're watching the films, was there areas you thought, oh, I've seen that before? Or again, was it new to you and think, well, where could that be? And you know, maybe I have to check it out sometime. And that's what it's kind of about. It's really trying to showcase this amazing area and also bits and pieces that you might not have seen before. We're now going to move on to our second set of three films for you. So ladies and gentlemen, get ready. It's now time for our films 4 to 6.
My name's Cheryl Jeske. I'm a resident in Bowdoin. I've lived in the area since 1980. I do enjoy bringing colour to people's lives. 9th Street is a thoroughfare street for cyclists. There are so many people that they asked if I'd come around and do their poll. So I chose Iconic Women as a project because there are so many beautiful iconic women that mean a lot to me, and they've influenced their careers, they've brought joy to the world. So it's really important to bring them to 9th Street. With Marilyn, Frida and Audrey, they were all done on pop art theme. Julia Gillard is Australia's first female Prime Minister, whereas Zaha Hadid is an international architect. Malala Yousafzai, she's a Muslim girl and she won the Nobel Prize for humanitarian. The different genres, advertising, TV. So this project has really enhanced communication between the residents of 9th Street. I realised how much I really love that connection with the local people. This project has still got another year to go. The world as it is at the moment needs all the colour it can get. It's just an easy way to bring colour to your street and to the world. Just pick up a paintbrush and paint a stobie pole.
Well, there we go, that's our films 4 to 6. Well done if you're one of those filmmakers, great job. Okay, well, if you were with us in 2018 and you did submit a film for the film festival back then, you would have come along to our Gala Award night at the Woodville Town Hall. It was a very lavish evening. There was tables dressed out. There was you know, amazing costumes and ball gowns, and there was paparazzi at the front door. Unfortunately, we can't do that this year, as you know, as I mentioned earlier. But instead, you have got myself in this sexy red velvet and this wonderful blue backdrop behind you. But we did have some very kind and local businesses who did want to sponsor the event. And here they are.
Our journey starts in Adelaide with a short train ride to Bowdoin.
Now arriving at Bowdoin.
And then we walk to Drayton Street, to an unassuming building amongst the urban decay. What lies behind the green facade? People making pizza, one stretching dough, or the other cooks. And crowds of joy sitting and standing among the foliage. Cold beer, fresh from the mismatched taps. We cheer and we drink. A glass of white wine and more beer. Pizza is being freshly made and cooked in the wood-fired oven on the back of Sonny's truck and delivered to the happiness and thanks of those who receive. Cold beer, fresh from the mismatched taps. The summer party rolls on. Luscious red wine and delightful white wine made right here in this building. The summer party rolls on. We dance with our pets and we thank Ordeal for this marvellous fest. But as day turns into night, parties must end. We wish Ordeal the very best.
Well, there we go, ladies and gentlemen. That was our final 3 years for this year's competition. Again, if you did submit a film this year, give yourself a massive pat on the back and a round of applause. And also, hopefully, people in the living room with you, or the kitchen, or the garden, or wherever you're watching this, can also give them a round of applause as well, Kurt, for doing a great job. The thing I love about this competition is that, you know, firstly, it's free, which is fantastic. It also gives the opportunity for, you know, hobby filmmakers, established filmmakers to come together, make creative content, and win prizes. We have got some amazing prizes to give away from our competition sponsors. So it is now time to get started and find out our first winner of the first category, which is Best Film for 12 to 18 years, goes to Don't worry if you haven't won a prize just yet. There's still many categories to go. We're now going to move on to our next category, which is community film. Best of luck. And the winner is I think we can all agree there were some amazing shots in our films this year, but there can only be one winner for cinematography, and the winner is
Street. I realised how much I really love that connection with the local people. This project has still got another year to go. The world as it is at the moment needs all the colour it can get. It's just an easy way to bring colour to your street and to the world. Just pick up a paintbrush and paint a stoby pole.
Okay, it's now time to move on to our next category. So it's time to find out the winner of Best Direction. So the winner is
where you can actually, for a moment, have a glimpse of what this place was like before roads, before houses, before shopping centres. To be able to come here just in a few minutes from my own local backyard.
It's now time for our final category, which is worth, I can't believe it myself, $1,000 and a trophy. Who really cares about the trophy? It's $1,000 you want, right? I just want to say again a massive well done to all of our filmmakers for having a go, whether it was your first film or you've established or you just want to have a go at it. Again, well done for actually doing it, submitting a film and being part of the competition this year. Well, it is now time to announce the winner, taking away $1,000. $1,000 and this year's, you know, bragging rights. We can walk around town saying you've got the best film for the Westside Film Festival. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it is now time for our final category, the best film. And the winner is
So I chose Iconic Women as a project because there are so many beautiful iconic women that mean a lot to me, and they've influenced their careers, they've brought joy to the world, so it's really important to bring them to 9th Street.
Well done, winning $1,000. What are you going to spend it on? I will spend mine on lots of Lego sets, I think. Again, well done to all of you for taking part this year. There's been some fantastic films. We've loved watching, we've loved sharing them with you. Also, we want to say a special thank you, of course, to the City of Charles Sturt for actually putting this event on and believing in filmmaking, believing in creativity, and, you know, supporting what that stands for in the local community. So thank you to them. Also, thank you to, again, all of our competition sponsors. And obviously, we didn't have the Gala Award dinner, but our event sponsors still want to be part of it, and thank you to them as well. Also, thank you to myself for looking gorgeous and being on your screen for the last few hours or so, and hopefully we'll see you back in the future. From myself, Mark, from All Sourced Up, and the City of Charles Sturt, and the Westside Film Festival, thank you so much for being part of it, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
part of the Westside Film Competition. The students and staff from the Palms had a fun time filming in our hidden gem, Apex Park. We wish everyone all the best.
Good luck!